Kathy Gonzalez. I talk about the narrative and media literacy as influential factor in the efficacy of programs for the prevention of teenage pregnancy. Unwanted pregnancy in Ecuador is a health public problem. The Latin America and the Caribbean make up region in which boys to girls between 15 years old have most increased. The government of Ecuador, under the National Strategic Well-Being Plan, projects a 15% reduction in the fertility rate for girls between 15 and 19 years old by 2030 through integral sexual education programs. Studies have shown that various physical social factors affect the risky sexual behavior, such as lack of information and poor access to sexual and reproductive healthcare service, impulsivity indecision, illusion of invulnerability, machismo and marianismo, silence culture where teens have hardly any possibilities of self-expression without judgment, and gender inequality, the use of substances such as alcohol and drugs, socioeconomic disadvantage, early start of sexual activity, among other reasons. The persuasive narrative. A persuasive narrative refers to messages which tend to promote healthy behavior or and portray the negatives of risk. Much study, interesting result. Interesting results have also been found on the effects that persuasive narratives produce through educational entertainment videos. Videos for change in attitudes, beliefs, and behavior in the area of health. In recent years, the effectiveness of educational entertainment has been studied and it applies to health communication. Channel MTV has had a program about teen pregnancy called 16 and Pregnant, and it's a spin-off called Teen Mom. This format has been replicated in other Ibero-American countries, for example, in Spain, in Chile. Studies have examined the way they are watched, their consequence, and discussion about this program. The results indicate negative and positive aspects on the effectiveness of the reality show. Media literacy. Media literacy has been studied as a factor in the level of critical skills used by teens, which make them more critical in the face of media products that try or convince them of something. This investigation intends to analyze whether the level of critical thinking on the adolescent competent in media influence the impact of narrative that mediates attitudes, knowledges, behaviors, and perceived vulnerability. I will produce two short films, one self-narrative and other with narrative with consecutive dialogues. Hypothesis. My hypothesis, I have to read. The self-narrative compared to the narrative short with consecutive dialogues will cause adolescents to identify more with each of the characters. The transportation by this type of narrative increase and therefore decrease the counteract, which in turn will encourage the increased knowledge attitudes in danger of preventing behavior, reduce misconceptions, and increase the perceived vulnerability. However, this mediation process will manifest only among teens with low level of media competence. Methodology. The unit of analysis will be 200 adolescent females of 15 years old that studied at public school in the city of Cuenca, Ecuador. A pretest will be applied to measure the level of media competence. At the same time, their beliefs, attitudes, knowledges, and intention of behavior and perceived vulnerability. After 2 weeks, the same things will be separated into two random groups. They will see two short films. Group A, self-narrative short film, and Group B, the narrative with consecutive dialogues short films. Post-test. After 2 weeks, will be applied a post-test questionnaire for measure the effects of the each format. Measures, knowledges, beliefs, attitudes, intention, and behavior will be measured with a questionnaire at all. Perceived vulnerability and counter-arguing, a major goals scale will be used. Identification with characters, we will measure with a scale of 11 items used in Igartua and Vega. For media competence, I will use questionnaire of dimensions of Perez and Pichitelli. A model 7 developed by Andrew Hayes and Marco Process for SPSS will be used for measure the indirectal. Se me fue el nombre de indirect effects. And my contribution, this is too very important for my country to try to find solutions about this social problem. Thank you for your attention.